Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and if you're new here, welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to show you how you can change the color of almost anything in your video without the need to download or install any plugins. Let's jump right into Final Cut Pro and get started. We'll start off with a simple example and isolate the blue color in our model's dress. Place your playhead where the color is clearly visible and head up to the inspector window. Select the color inspector and from the corrections drop-down menu, select Hue Saturation Curves. Down in the Hue versus Saturation curve, select the eyedropper button on the right-hand side. Over in the viewer window, click and drag out a sample of the color you want to isolate. Back in the Hue versus Saturation curve, you get three control points. The middle point is the hue you selected, and the points on each side limit the hue range. Grab each one of these outside points and drag straight down to desaturate all the colors except your selected hue. You can also drag up a bit on the middle point to add more vibrancy to your selected color. In just a few easy steps, we have the school Sin City style effect. In our next example, we'll do the same thing, except this time, go one step further and make the model's dress change color throughout the clip. Just like before, place your playhead over the clip, go up to the color inspector, and in the hue versus saturation curve, isolate the color of the dress. Drag the outside control points in towards the middle to make sure no extra colors are selected. Next, move your playhead to the frame where you want the dress to change color and press Command B to blade your clip. Select the second part of the clip and go back to the hue versus saturation curves. This time, select the eyedropper in the hue versus hue curve and in the viewer window, sample the color you want to change. Move your middle control point up or down to select the desired color for the dress. Let's go with yellow. Repeat this as many times as you need to make the model's dress different colors. Now, for the end of this clip, let's fade back to the original color and fade in the background colors. Place your playhead where you want the fade to start, and in the inspector window, add a keyframe to the hue versus saturation curves. Move your playhead ahead about 20 frames, and drag all the control points back up to the middle. Here's our finished result. Both these examples were nice and easy because there's no similar colors in either one of the clips. For our next clip, let's isolate just the model's lips. But because her shirt is a very similar color, this one will be quite a bit harder, but still possible. Before we do, I'd like to take a minute to talk about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. If you make videos for a living, or even if it's just a hobby, you need to check out Envato Elements. They have millions of high quality assets for your next project, including stock video, royalty free music and sound effects, video templates, graphic templates, and so much more. And the best part? Everything Envato Elements has to offer is included in one simple subscription. I've been using Envato Elements for almost as long as I've had this channel and still go back there pretty much for every video. Check it out and see how Envato Elements can help you make better videos. Now back to Final Cut Pro. Just like before, use a hue versus saturation curve to isolate your color. As you can see, because there is other similar colors in this clip, selecting just the lips isn't possible. Sometimes dragging in on the outside points will help, but not in this case. To isolate just the lips, we have to use a mask, and since our model moves, we have to track her movement. This is a perfect place to use Final Cut Pro's built-in tracker. Go back to the video inspector and scroll all the way down to trackers. Click the plus button to bring up the tracking grid. Tracking the lips in this example would be a little bit tricky since they change shape quite a bit as our model smiles. To get the best tracking result, let's pick an area on our model with similar movement that doesn't change shape as much. I think one of our model's eyes would work much better. Move the tracking grid over the model's eye and change the size and rotation of it. The smaller you can make this, the better your track will be. Click the Analyze button to track your clip. Once your track is finished, click Done and go back to the video inspector. If you hover over the hue versus saturation curve parameter, you'll see a little mask button show up on the right-hand side. Click on this button and select Add Shape Mask. Position the mask over your subject's lips. Use the green control points to resize it. Go back to the color inspector. Select the area outside your mask and bring down the saturation by dragging down the control point beside the hue versus saturation curve. The last thing we need to do is add the tracking data from before to this mask so it moves with our subject. Over in the viewer window, click the down arrow beside the track button and select the tracking data from your previous step. Render out your clip and here's our finished result. There's a lot of cool things you can do with the color tools in Final Cut Pro. And with the addition of object tracking in the 10.6 update, now you can do even more. If you want to learn more about object tracking in Final Cut Pro, watch this video right here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.